Mesdames et messieurs, bonjour. J'ai reçu avec beaucoup de plaisir mon collègue ami John Kerry. Nous avons abordé des sujets qui ne sont pas faciles, mais qui évidemment concernent les États-Unis et la France et beaucoup d'autres. Nous avons parlé de ce qui se passe en Irak et en Syrie, puisque vous savez que les États-Unis et la France sont engagés pour lutter contre Daesh, et nous avons fait le point sur les actions actuelles et puis ce que nous pourrions faire dans le futur. Nous avons abordé longuement la question de la négociation avec l'Iran au sujet des nucléaires, puisque nous travaillons dans le cadre de ce qu'on appelle le 5 plus 1 et qu'un butoir dans le temps est donné au 24 novembre. Donc, c'est très important que les États-Unis et la France puissent avoir une position identique en répétant ce qui est le fond de notre position. L'Iran a parfaitement le droit d'utiliser le nucléaire civil, l'énergie nucléaire civile, mais la bombe atomique, non. Et c'est à partir de cela qu'il y a des discussions qui sont menées et qui vont continuer d'être menées. Nous avons bien évidemment parlé aussi de la situation au Liban, de la façon dont se pose aujourd'hui la question israélo-palestinienne. Et nous sommes très habitués, John Kerry et moi-même, à discuter de ces sujets. Il est extrêmement important que les États-Unis et la France se concertent parce que nos valeurs, vous le savez bien, nos valeurs démocratiques sont les mêmes. Voilà. John.
Merci. Thank you, Laurent. As Foreign Minister Fabius has just said to you, we had a broad discussion on all of the topics that he mentioned to you. We agree that we are living in very, very complicated times with enormous challenges. But we also believe that we are up to those challenges. And whether it is Ebola or ISIL, Syria, Iraq, the challenge of the nuclear program in Iran, Afghanistan, France and the United States are cooperating more than ever before. Hand in hand, closely, driven by our values, as Laurent said, and mindful of the fact that the world is looking for leadership on these issues. We did talk, as he said, about our approaches to and our concerns about the negotiations with respect to Iran's program, and I agree with Laurent. They have a right to a peaceful program, but not a track to a bomb. We believe it is pretty easy to prove to the world that a plan is peaceful. And so we talked today about our common positions, about our common interests. We are hand in hand, linked in this effort, and we will work extremely closely together in the next weeks to try to find a successful path. In addition, we are very committed to continuing to press for the stability and ability to find peace in the Middle East. We talked about that today. We both have deep concerns about the continued settlements that are taking place and the need for all parties involved to avoid confrontation and try to find a way back to the negotiations, which are critical and the only way in the end to be able to bring about the stability and peace that people want. So there are many challenges beyond even the ones we talked today: Libya, North Africa, counterterrorism. But I'm very grateful to Laurent Fabius for the leadership of France, for their engagement, for their initiative individually in certain countries, Mali, elsewhere, Central African Republic, where France has been willing to take the lead and help to make a difference. And we remain committed, particularly in these next weeks when so much is at stake, to continuing to work together extremely closely. So I'm grateful for the opportunity to be here today, and I thank Laurent for his good counsel and for his good food.
Thank you. Merci.